Yeah, I've seen it myself. Yeah, it's reckless. Up for days and days at a time, doing all that shit, doing speed and pills and coke, all that stuff to stay keeps you awake. So
yeah,
and even Ritalin too often, too much for some people.
So, yeah,
you know, that's a lack of sleep agent, Adderall, and all that stuff.
All that.
You know, if you're not careful. So,
yeah, and like,
some of these things aren't very good for people's minds. Even if the doctor says you should take it, some of the times the stuff is really not good for you.
Anyway. Most of the time, though, you know, I think that, you know, I feel like certain things are helpful, you know, for certain people. I wouldn't say don't take it. Take your medicine if you need it, you know what I'm saying.
But if you reach the point where something is telling you and you know it's true, but then,
right,
like that, it's something's better, you're better off without this or that, maybe you should pay heed to that warning.
Yeah.
From your psyche.
Yeah, exactly. Some things are just bad for you.
Some medicines, they might rate them as safe by the FDA or whatever, but the truth of it, well, it's usually, it's often something completely different.
Right.
You know, and so it's not safe, not long term.
Yeah, but I understand that. Yeah.
It's just, you know, the best medicine is healing yourself. So you can learn how to heal yourself through positive thinking. Actually, that eliminates a lot of the original illnesses that might have been caused by negativity.
Yeah.
Like, a lot of people do get sick, you know, because they're negative people, and that can make them become ill.
Right.
You know, physically, thinking negatively.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, I think it does make a big difference on your own thought patterns, you know, as far as how well you feel, you know, if you think negative about yourself.
So, yeah. Well, we're apologizing. We're getting like sort of a slow start today, you know, but this is an opening video. You know, I feel kind of, today I've had a slow start, but just thinking about so much stuff, and yeah, so much worry on my mind, and it's come to see that it's really no point worrying about what I've been worrying about. You know, just what's happening in our future is what's going to happen. Same thing we teach all you guys, where you decide you have to go with what comes. And like, of course, I know things are coming, and I have called them to me with my thoughts, and along with other people's thoughts. And they're here, a lot of them, and more on the way. So it's not like I can be like, oh, no, I'm not going to sign for the package. You know, I ordered it, but hell no, I'm not paying the bill, or I'm not signing for that FedEx package. It's not like that with the universe. It really comes to you. You need to go ahead and accept it before you can move on to something else. So I have to accept it. So, and so to say, and we had no choice in it. And because we said we had no choice, we made it our work, you know. And we created that reality for ourselves. And here we are. You know, and that's maybe our struggle will teach you something about not second guessing yourself. Like, some people like feel drawn to start their own businesses, quit their jobs, start their own business. If, like, for example, I can see how some people who are used to having a job and doing the same thing every week and having that routine,
yeah,
and that money, and if it suddenly changes, it can be difficult, that routine.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's kind of just like that. It can be hard. It can be hard to make that change, you know, where you're like, you know, I've got to quit my job. I want to do what I love, and I found what I love, and it's time for me to change my routine. When that point gets there, it's hard. That's always
struggle.
Difficult.
Struggle, you know.
To break your routine.
Yeah.
I'm being honest, you know, about this. Sometimes, like, I look at the future that's coming, and, you know, people respect what we do. You know, I'm not saying that arrogantly, but they do. We get it all the time from a lot of friends, a lot of people we don't even know, even. have come up and complimented us on the videos and what we do and so
thank
forth.
You very much.
And we appreciate to all y'all who took the time to speak to us and call or just say hi out when we're out in public.
Yeah.
We really appreciate it, but it helps, believe it. It does help.
Yeah.
So, you know, but it just goes to show us that we're here, we have a job to do. It's our,
yeah,
it's here.
Yeah, we have our own thing we have to get over, you know, sometimes, you know, wondering about the future, seeing it, you know, I see it playing out so well, like us with all these different types of famous people talking, you know, we had that conversation, you know, and I could see all these different people.
Mm-hmm. You know, I can see it too. I've seen something like that. Not that I even want to talk to them. It's that they're seeking us out.
Yeah.
You know, they want to talk to us.
It's just random people, like not even people that we necessarily like hype up in our own mind. You know,
a lot of them aren't even people we even know about, right?
Yeah.
We've heard of them, but then they all of a sudden like, well, this so and so is coming. And some of them we have heard of. But
yeah, like what did I say? Morgan Freeman.
Yeah. That's just,
that was really random.
That is like, we go by first impressions, so
yeah,
you saw that as a first impression.
Yeah.
Very well could happen.
How did we do meet Morgan Freeman? It was very nice. And we could tell him a lot about his life, you know, and his future, you know.
That's where they probably come, because I see people like that being interested. Someone who's famous is really no different than anyone else, but
no.
You know, like they'll come to us too. I can see that's what I look at. That doesn't scare me. That I'll talk to anybody. That's all I don't know. I'll talk to anyone. But looking at that, man, it's just we'll definitely can help some people out. I know that much.
Drives me to a little bit, man. Thinking about sitting with some of these people, man.
Not me. Me. I'll sit and talk with anybody.
I honestly would be a little starstruck, you know, sometimes, you know. You know, like you said, Jay-Z, probably hang out with Jay-Z, you know.
Yeah, I'd see him.
I would be a little starstruck, you know.
I'd have to sit down and start talking with
them. Oh, yeah, I'd be cool.
Because, I mean, they probably don't want to be treated like that.
No.
I can see that in their minds.
You know me, man. I would be very cool and hang out.
We just hang out like they know, but it'd be like, what's up?
But I would be like shaking like a leaf in excitement, you know what I'm saying?
You gotta learn how to do that, you know? It's the way I think, like, I can see us just sitting here. He walks in and Jay-Z walks in, for example, or something. I just turn on, what's going on, man? It's a dap or whatever. It's like this, as calm as this. I can definitely see him.
Yeah, that'd be pretty cool.
I look, I see him right here. I almost do like a role play.
Yeah.
I'll be like, well, what's going on, man? You know?
But see, I would say, like, we do.
I'd be like, look, glad to have you here. You know, what's up, man? What can we do for it?
I would tell him immediately, though, man, that I really respect his music.
You should learn that.
That I'm a big fan of yours, you know, so it's really good to have you here, you know. That'd be, you know, very excited that I saw him, man, you know.
Yeah, I'd be like, you know, very much, you know, I'd be like, look, my brother, appreciate you coming, you know, and we know we're here to help, we help everybody, so I was like, so he's like, man, you know, I saw some of your videos on the internet, I just see it, like, you know, Jeremy and I can role play almost anything psychically, you know, psychic mind,
and
we can see it really happening, I've seen it now, but we could see all the possibilities and play them out if we want. But we could go into that, but we have, what time is it? 3:11. We got plenty of time. We got 40 minutes.
40 minutes. Right?
Yeah.
All right.
Time is passing now. Yesterday's 1 hour video clip went by. Like, it felt like 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Today's time is a little bit longer.
Yeah. So we're going to slow it. It's all right.
It's okay, though.
We're just here speaking truth.
And we'll do it just for everyday people, too. I don't know, that's the word I like to use, the term everyday people. Maybe it's not the best, but, you know, everyday people is like what I think of is those of us just out there doing everyday things, just trying to get by, everyday jobs, doing whatever, trying to get by, pay their bills, everyday ordinary people, you know, in this particular country or wherever.